presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, Strike King Lure Company, St. Croix Rods.
Kesagami Wilderness Lodge. Everyone knows it. You've seen it on TV, you read magazines about it, you've seen it on social media. Something about this place is magical. It's always about those big, giant, gator-like pike. But this boy's going there for those walleyes. I've seen the brochures. I've talked to Charlie at the trade shows. He says, Carl, seriously, 100 walleye days. And you know, I'm just like anybody else. You know, I have a little bit of skepticism when somebody says 100 walleyes. That's a lot of walleyes. I'm not going to fish from 5 a.m. to 10 p.m. But no, it is true. This place is magical when it comes to walleye. All right, we do the fly-in. We're here at Kesagami, and it's great. Just a perfect weather. You know, we couldn't ask for anything more perfect. Nice place. It's got the accommodations that everybody raves about, the meals that are mouth-watering, but it's the walleyes that I've come for. So we get here, we set up, they hook us up with Pat, one of the guides, and they have like dock hands. They have a real well-oiled machine here. And Charlie at the top of the totem pole there, he just, you know, helps everybody make this place run as smooth gets. Like they're there, they get your luggage, they put it in your cabin, in your place you're staying. You know, you have breakfast or lunch ready, depends what time you come in on the planes. And then you decide to hook up with Pat. We go out to one of the first spots, and lo and behold, sunny, bright, we're only about 5 feet of water, and I start pounding on the walleye.
At that time. Oh man, oh man, is there a lot of walleyes here? Is there a lot of walleyes here? Look at this. Just beautiful walleye, man. Wow, right in the schnoz. Hey, walleye's like, come on, just get me, take me out. Wow, wow, wow. Gorgeous, gorgeous, eh? Oh, I might keep one for lunch. One for lunch. Let's see if I can get another one right away. Ethan was put my... Not that time. Just so many gorgeous fish. Sure. Hey, you're doing an awesome job, man. Putting me on them. Unhooking them. So many 16s and a half, 17. Yeah, they're gorgeous fish. You would not starve in Kesagami, would you? And what's the deal? A couple of walleyes around 18 and under, right, for lunch? That's a deal? Yeah, okay.
How simple is simple? Think about walleyes. There's one criteria here that you have to remember. It's catch and release. That sustains this fishery. That this lodge was really innovative years ago with introducing the catch and release program. A little bit of blowback, you know, from people that maybe came to areas that filled up the coolers and brought fish home, but that's not the days anymore. You want to come to areas that have potential 100 walleye days. And because Kesagami did that years ago, this is the kind of fishery they have now. And it's such an easy way to fish. Curly-tailed grub in bright yellow with chartreuse head will get it done.
Yeah, on top. And that's walleye, it's pretty good. Might be northern. Oh, that's good walleye. Oh boy. Look where he is, right to the nose too, huh? Wow. Yeah, I can get a little splish splash. Maybe splash of the air. Look how he's got that, right? He couldn't get any tighter. Watch, I won't even touch him. Wow, what a fishery. Try another bait, the little 2.75 inch striking rage swimmer. You know why? It is so much fun catching these fish. But like Pat said, there's definitely some bigger walleyes here. Maybe that little bit bigger meat of the rage swimmer might catch me some bigger walleyes.
Oh, that didn't take long.
And nice walleye too. Up high. Oh, I just seen somebody just miss him. I think there's a pike there.
Something coming after him.
Yeah, I just saw him. Look at, he just went dormant. I think he saw him too.
Oh, nice fish.
I just put on the little raid swimmer. And you know what? I did see something there, because this walleye went just stagnant. Nice chunky walleyes, boy oh boy. But I'm still looking for that 18, 19, 20. And I upsized to the little rage kicking swimmer. Look at that thing right there. Quarter ounce, first cast. The thumping tail, bang.
Okay, day two. Wake up and it's again, perfect morning. Flat calm, sunny, warm. You say, flat calm, warm, sunny, good for walleyes? Remember where we are, the island of Kesagami, and the walleyes are waiting. Had another fantastic breakfast. We go out, first spot we go to, it's like the first or second cast, ding, tick. It's almost surreal how many walleyes are at this place.
Nice. It's silly. This one doesn't know he's hooked. He doesn't know he's hooked. Well, now he does. Another decent fish, look at that.
Beautiful.
Hey? Your average size of one of those 16, 17s are phenomenal.
Oh yeah, nice for the pen too.
Pen, okay.
I think so.
Lodge guide says one for the pen. Another one for the pen. Okay.
Oh, we gotta feed the boss.
So what's the deal with the harvesting then? Let the people know. Two fish under 18?
Yes. One over. We try not to keep the ones that are over just for conservation and whatnot.
Yeah.
So we usually just keep the smaller ones that we catch, just enough for lunch, and then throw everything else back to live another day.
So max two per person, that's more than enough.
Oh, that's plenty.
That's four fillets, man. I can't eat four.
Yeah, so when we're with a group, we, if it's a smaller person, like a kid or a smaller woman kind of thing, then we'll only keep one fish. Or even two of them, because they'll only eat one piece of fish.
Then yeah.
You got the potatoes, onions, beans, all that. So
yeah.
Just keep as little as we can and throw everything else back. I think it's helped a lot.
Yeah, man. That's why the fishery is world class, right?
Lots of fish in the lake, that's for sure.
World class. Wow. Well, let's see if we can catch some more right here, right now. Right there. I'll put it past that way, where I haven't touched yet. Yeah, we're on top of the rock. Wow, I saw you. Ooh. I saw you. Wow, dude, that was worth the price of admission. I saw that fish come up when I saw the rocks, my friend. And the friendly guide is gonna help. That fish earned his keep, dude. He earned his release. I watched him come up and go whack.
Unbelievable. I got a mark right under the bow, right before you hooked him. Beautiful fish.
Oh my goodness, Pat, let's let him swim, huh? Wow.
Awesome.
Gone but not forgotten. And I'm right back into the cast. I was casting all the way out there and he hit. Look at the cloud cover, folks, right there. It was bright and sunny and calm first thing. And now he ate it with about 4 feet of line out, man. Up on top of the rocks. That was incredible to see that. I'm watching my bait and then it just disappears. Priceless. Wow, is that fun, man? Come on, boys. That bite is so violent. Whack! Violent. Uh-oh. Look at that walleye. How many walleyes? The poor guy just has to keep getting up every. That size right there, Pat, I would say there's probably hundreds right here, isn't there?
Oh, exactly. Must be. They're really eating this one. Nice.
Perfect lodge walleye. You talk about simple. Now, with catch and release, what better way to make sure that you have a fantastic fishery for years and generations to come, where you take your pliers and you bend down the barbs? Sure, you can lose a few fish, but so what? Just cast out and catch some more, really. But you bend down the barbs, so all you gotta do is when they catch a fish, bring it in, pop the jig head back down, pull the jig out of its mouth, fish is released, that's it. I had the school all turned on. The school was in session. I gotta wake them up again. No, I don't. because they're right here. Oh, good walleye too. Look at this thing, dude. Look at that one. Look at that walleye.
You may want to lift that one and just snap your line.
Yeah. See? Come here, boy. Come here. Gorgeous walleye, man. Look at that. Look at that, man. Gorgeous Kesagami walleye. Go on, boy. Go on down. And now it's time for the extreme edge. Here's something we're gonna use all the tools of our boat. Those two things back there, you say, well, he's always using them, the power poles. I'll show you why on this segment, because we're gonna fish early summer, shallow water, spooky bass in clear water. Heavily pressured lake, a lot of guys fish bass here. These fish see a lot of baits, and they see a lot of anglers. It's about making pitches like this, long pitches. Into that stuff, letting it settle, hop it, pop it, and it's not about fishing all the way back to the boat. This is about making those long pitches to the dark stuff I see, or the heavier clumps. You will learn to become a much better bass fisherman fishing in clear water as opposed to dirty water. Why? Very simple. You'll have to learn like a stealth-like ninja approach. Stay back, utilize things on your boat like the power poles, trolling motor, glasses, all the things you need to help you catch fish in clear water, because you can see how fish react, how they move. And you'd be surprised in clear water how many times you see fish in areas where you think, nope, going along, all of a sudden swims out. In dirty water, you'd have no idea. Looking at all the dark stuff, putting it in the dark stuff, holding on. There's one right there, look at that. Oh, geez, eh? And he's gone. I was just going to talk about the stretch of fluorocarbon. It's the best of both worlds because it's clear, but with braid, you get those instant penetration hook sets. But you probably won't get the same bites in the real clear water with braid. Fluorocarbon has that little bit of stretch that just doesn't penetrate, and that's what happens sometimes. They come off. So in this segment, what I'm going to do is fish with Strike King Rage Menace. And it's the KVD Magic. It's almost clear. It's gray with some green. It's got some blue flake, real scary tone. I got it pegged. And I got it only with 3/16 tungsten. And it's pegged. You say 3/16, this is for the real shallow stuff. I want it to fall slow in that clear water. I don't want it to go inside the mung, because sometimes it's not just sand or hard bottom. It's soft, and if it's too heavy, it goes in the mung. That's not what I want to happen. I want them to turn and eat it. On the business end, right here, is a St. Croix Legend X, and it's the 7/6 medium heavy. 20 pound gamma edge fluorocarbon, crystal clear water, and you know, sometimes I'm gonna lose fish, but so what? On the money end, Tatula low profile reel. That's my number one stick. Yep, look, see that? Pace to watch, huh? That's a good one, look at him. Good largy. And what did I just finish saying about how many spots I fished, eh? How many spots did I fish? Look where I got it to, right through the cheek. He ain't going anywhere but in the boat. Oh, sharp hooks. Not a bad largemouth right there. The start, the one I had was probably about that high, that long. But they just come off sometimes. Just decent 2 pound fish, huh? Hey, look how clear, look how green. Ready? Go on, look how he disappears inside there. Virtually invisible. Put those poles down again. I like how this looks. And then dissect it. I'm looking for spots. Okay, where? Where potentially is it gonna be? This dark stuff. Right there, close to the reeds, in the reeds. I'm pretty confident in this 20 pound test that I can put it in some nasty stuff and still pull the fish out. But remember, you gotta get bit first before you can catch them. Number two,
because I'm always prepared. You've got to be prepared. Once again, 7.4 Legend X, heavy action, or heavy power, sorry. Low profile, Tatula, or Daiwa, 20 pound again. This one has a 5/16 tungsten weight, offset, 4-rod wide gap hook, and the bait of choice, the rodent. The rodent finds them, helps you catch them. So these two baits, along clear water, reeds, oh, maybe I'll fish boathouses and stuff, but mostly it's going to be reeds. It's early summer. Fishers tend to, after they spawn and do things, they just go back and cruise around those areas looking for food, sunfish and bluegills and stuff. And if they see your rodent or rage menace, they're going to eat it. Sort of like that. Oh, lordy, lordy, eh? There you. Ah, just like that. That's what it takes in the clear water. Take different baits. Using that menace for a while. And then hooked up with the rodent. Rodent definitely did it. That's a pretty big fish. Take some pictures and let them go pretty quick. 5 pounds of beautiful largemouth in clear water. What is the bait that's caught some of the biggest bass on Extreme Angler or even Canadian television for that matter? You say, wow, it's a bold statement. The truth is what the truth is. The truth is the rodent.
I think one of the biggest draws for Kesagami Lodge is the full experience. We are famous for our trophy pike fishing. We're also famous for our walleye fishing. I mean, it's nonstop. However, Kesagami really offers more than just the fishing. We have a full service lodge. All the meals are included. You start with a 1-hour float plane ride out of Cochrane, Ontario. You fly into the northern wilderness. We have our own secluded spot inside Kesagami Provincial Park. So we're actually in a wilderness class provincial park. At Kesagami, we have a very short primetime season. We're only open for 9 weeks every year, starting the end of May and finishing the end of July. We want to keep people fishing only when they're going to catch fish and in the best fishing times possible. We can accommodate up to 45 people here at Kesagami in 10 motel style rooms where everybody has their own private bathroom. And we also have 7 cabins that are serviced by a bathhouse. We have a great waterfront staff, and in fact, we have a very high staff to guest ratio. We'll have 20 to 22 staff to take care of a maximum of 45 guests. Guys will help you in and out of the boats. We have a full service bar. We have daily maid service. We have servers that help you with the food. And the whole experience is really for you to relax. All you have to do is fish, eat, and sleep, and we take care of everything for you. At Kesagami, we actually have set the gold standard for fishing lodges pretty well in Canada. Our Google reviews are 5-star, our TripAdvisor reviews are 5-star. And I always recommend that people go to TripAdvisor because we don't have control of those reviews, and you can hear the reality of the experience here from the real people that have been here. And it really is about the Kesagami experience. The total wilderness experience, you're well taken care of, you've got great fishing, great meals and accommodations, and it really is a full dream trip.
What you really have to consider when you come to Kesagami, or any lodge for that matter, the guides here know the water. And when you're planning your trip, you know, your budget, how many guys you have, consider that, because they'll take all the guesswork out. They'll put you right on the fish. They'll know where the fish are biting, how they're biting, what depth, what baits. It eliminates a lot of guesswork, and it just increases your chances to have a lot more fun with you and your buddies. On bottom. Oh, I missed a fish right there. Wow. Not that time. Wow. Look at that. Oh, that's a gorgeous walleye. That's a beautiful, look at this one. One of the better ones I've caught. Look at that. Oh, going to the cradle, girl. Look at that.
Nice.
Gorgeous walleye. Beautiful. Gorgeous walleye. Sharp hooks are a must because with the barbless hooks, bend and out. right walleye. I'm just holding you by the outside of the gill plate here. Let's see ya, hey? Bye. Wow, man, new spot, same results, except even bigger walleyes. Wow. Repeat, try it again. And just a slow retrieve. Look at that. I know that there's fish are there. I'm gonna get him. Like that.
There he is.
Oh my goodness. Dude, this is another good one. Look at that white tail. Look how long this one is. Look at that. Hey, isn't that gorgeous? Kesagami's finest. Pat the guide, look at that. How many walleyes have you touched in the 2 days with me, dude?
Yeah.
How many? Lots, right?
I've lost count, yeah. Quite a few.
But that's what I'm talking about in Kesagami. Catching and releasing. This place truly is a bucket list for anybody who loves to fish. Think about Kesagami Wilderness Lodge because it is the place that you'll come once and you'll never forget it.
Extreme Angler has been presented by Ontario, Canada, in partnership with Destination Ontario, St. Croix Rods, Strike King Lure Company, Rage Tail Soft Baits, Gamma Fishing Lines, Power Pole. Visit us at fishextreme.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.